Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Swasti. So today is Teacher's Day. So first of all, I just want to wish every teacher and actually every person out there in the world a very happy Teacher's Day, because all of us, no matter who we are, where we are, how young or how old we are, what profession we are, we all are teachers in our own little way. So a very happy Teacher's Day to them, all of you, right? Now I've personally believed, like, for the last 4-5 years that life is our greatest teacher. Like, you know, there's no teacher bigger than life, and of course it's also my personal favorite teacher because it's always practical and nothing theory. I don't have to learn anything, plus there are no marks, just consequences. But anyway, so the thing is, we learn so much from life, right? Every day, every moment, we are learning something new. And that all comes from life. Everything that we learn in our life is a part of life, right? I think I've said life too many times already, but yeah. So I just wanted to do this video where I talk about the top and, like, the most important 5 things that I've learned from life, because there's literally so much that I've learned from life, and I don't know if it's gonna be relatable to you all, but I really wanted to do this, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna do it. The first thing that I'm going to be talking about is acceptance. Now, this is one of the most important lessons that I've learned in my life, is that to accept things the way they are and not with emotions attached to it, right? So if something has happened, it may be very good, it may be very bad, it may be normal, whatever has happened, if we accept those actions, it becomes a lot more easier for us to deal with it in life. And I can't tell you the number of things that I have constantly been able to deal with in a much better and progressive way just because I was able to accept that it has happened. You know, what happens is, because we do not accept what has happened, we keep on thinking about so many other things that we are unable to deal with it. We go into denial, or, you know, it's always accompanied with a lot of emotions. So I personally believe if we are able to accept those actions or the things that have happened in our life, it'll be much more easier for us to deal with things, you know, because it gives you a certain kind of peace, because, you know, you're like, you know what, that has happened, so that knowledge that XYZ is happening is not gonna affect me anymore. Of course the consequences and other things are gonna affect me, but that particular action has already happened and it's actually in the past. So that acceptance that, okay, it's happened or it's happening, is very important. And personally I feel that whatever little sanity I have in my life, it comes from accepting things that have happened to me. Number two is understanding. Now there are, like, two aspects to understanding that I want to talk about. The first is understanding why someone is doing something. So, you know, understanding people, because again, once you understand someone, you are able to understand why they are doing what they are doing, so then their actions don't hurt you in the way it would if you don't know why they are doing. Because if we understand people, if we put out energy to understand people, I feel it's gonna be easier for us to deal with their actions with less trouble. The second aspect of understanding that life has taught me is understanding others, of course, yeah, but it's about to be understanding towards them and of their actions. For a long time, I did not really have friends, I didn't fit in anywhere, and I always felt like no one would understand me. So that's why I never had friends to share my secrets to, like, to a point that I didn't even have friends to sit and have lunch with, right? Utna, like, I was that, I always felt like people will not understand me. That was a fact that I accepted. So well, obviously that's a different whole other story, but the point is that I always was looking for someone who would look beyond my overt actions and actually understand the emotions that I'm going through. And for a long time I didn't find anyone, and I guess that is when subconsciously I somewhere decided that I'm gonna try and always be there for people, and, you know, like, become that understanding person. I had read this quote a while ago, like quite a long while ago, that be the person you are looking for. I was always looking for a kind, understanding friend or even a stranger, because you never know how one kind word can change someone's life. So what I have tried, I'm still trying. I'm not saying I succeed every day, but it's definitely one of the greatest lessons of life that I try my best to be understanding and empathetic towards people. So whatever they're going through, what they're doing, I try my best to understand them and, you know, not judge them, because that's literally all you can do. It's already such a world where there's so much depression, tension, stress, anxiety. Literally every second person is going through something major in life, and on the outside we all are like sharing memes and laughing and like I don't know what we are doing, like this generation. But yeah, so you know, we are going through so much in life, but we don't say it. So if you can be that one understanding person for someone, I think we should be. I definitely try my best to be. I don't know how far successful I am, but yeah. Number three, one of the most important things I've learned in life is to forgive. No, and the thing is, it's a very famous thing, no, forget and forgive, but I don't believe in the forgetting part, because I feel, you know, we should remember what people have done to us so that we can maintain a certain distance from them. But I feel forgiving is very important, because until and unless we forgive people, we will not be able to make peace with it, right? Because for example, say if someone has done something wrong to you and they have left, right, they are not in your life anymore, they have done it and you are wallowing and hurting and you are troubled in your personal atmosphere right now, but that person has like left the chat and gone, right? But the thing is, since we are unable to forgive them, that is why we feel like they're still a part of our life. But actually the truth is, they have hurt you and gone, and they don't really care anymore. So for your own peace, for your satisfaction, it's very important for us to, number one, believe in karma. It's karma, but it's karma in pop culture, so it's karma. To believe in karma and let the universe figure it out, because, and secondly, just forgive them, because once we forgive them, I feel like we personally detach them, ourselves from them, right? We are like, you know what, okay, you're a shit person, but like I don't want to hold grudges against you, so I'm gonna forgive you. But yeah, like, you know, I don't want to be near you anymore. And number four, yeah, so number four that I've learned from life is, again, one of the most important lessons is to be grateful, okay? Because you know, there is so much in life that we have and we don't really realize it. I mean, of course there are other things in life that we achieve, that we are aiming for, but it's really important for us, I feel, like personally I feel it's really important to be grateful for what we have. Because the point is, something that you were wishing for a few months ago, if it's in your hands right now, you know, if you are like living that life, or that we don't really realize it because we get caught up, but it's really important to be grateful. Because I think your own happiness somewhere comes from gratefulness. Because I feel if you are grateful to God or universe or whatever you believe in, and for that matter, if you're grateful to yourself, like for making through a hard time or for being in a good position now, whatever your belief is according to that, if we all are grateful, it makes us happier people, I feel, and it also controls our greed, I feel. And I'm not saying to constantly think about all the things that other people don't have but you have, but I'm just saying that every once in a while, when we feel down, if you just sit down and think about all the things in life that we were wishing for that we now have, I think we all will be in a better and a happier place mentally. Number five, and the most important lesson that I've learned from life is, again, a very corny thing. It's to live life, right? We're always so like thinking about either the past, or we are dreaming about the future or worrying about the future, that we forget that there's a life like that we are literally missing right now, because we are busy thinking about something else. And that's the whole thing, right? It's very important to live in the present and to live. By living, I don't mean like someone else's definition of living. For you, it can be staying at home and watching a movie or watching shows. It can be going out, can be, you know, working for 10 hours and being really productive and doing something that makes a change in the world, right? Whatever is your definition of living, I feel like we should do that. So I think it's really important for us to remember the things that make us happy and to do that, and, you know, basically live life to the fullest, because as Shah Rukh Khan says, kya pata kal hona ho, right? We really don't know kal kya hone wala hai, like kal kya ek ghante baad kya hone wala hai wo bhi nahi pata. So again, I think it's like very 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 important to live life and live in the present and live to the fullest, because babu mushai zindagi badi honi chahiye, lambi nahi, right? Okay, that's two dialogues in one video, so yeah, no more Bollywood or corny things to say. These were like the top 5 lessons that I have learned from life. I'm pretty sure to some level this video was relatable. I would really like if you guys could just drop in the comments and tell me what your biggest learning has been from life and if you're related to the video. And yeah, that's all I want to say. It's Teacher's Day today and I'm basically alone right now at home. My two most favorite teachers, my mom and my brother, are not here with me today. They're both out of station, and so there are a lot of thoughts and feelings that were just going on in my mind, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna record a video, you know. And like, we learn so much from life all day, every day, we all do. So like, how can we forget to wish life a very happy Teacher's Day, right? And if you like this video, please leave a like, drop a comment. I already told you, please drop a comment about what you felt about this video. Share it with all your teachers, all your friends, and share it in your life. And of course, please do subscribe to my channel. And yeah, that's it. Thanks. Bye.